Hi again, everyone. I know I've already talked about Sawtooth theory a lot, but I was recently reminded by a number of people that I haven't really verified whether the hypothesis actually stands up to scrutiny. I'd already gone over the problems with the video in my head and eventually came to my own rationalizations by the time I released the Universal Alicorn Transformation video. In hindsight, however, I probably should have made the video you're watching right now before I released the former. So, for the sake of being balanced, let's run over this one more time just to figure out where the strengths and weaknesses lie. The three points of the video are A. The Alicorn form is derived from a pony absorbing a specific type of magic. B. The specific type of magic is actually a combination of magic derived from all three main pony tribes, or what I like to call the three tribes hypothesis. And C, the reason Celestia and Luna always considered it more than that was because they became Alicorns immediately after successfully moving the Sun and Moon. First of all, what parts of the theory actually do make sense? Well, Cozy, Twilight and Flurryheart definitely could have gotten their magic this way. Not to mention the question of how Celestia and Luna got their wings is so all over the place you could arguably throw in any explanation you like, and even then, the one somewhat canon explanation we have still partially verifies the theory. What about Cadence? This one's a little bit trickier since Sawtooth doesn't really look into her origins within the books. Assuming the explanation given in the book Twilight Sparkle and the Crystal Heart spell is canon, it's possible her defeat of the love-draining spell also released some of the townspony's magic into her. Unfortunately, the way it's written is so vague you could read absolutely anything into it, so again, this one is a bit more debatable. Now for the bits that really don't add up. For starters, Sawtooth's theory doesn't really account for the Alicorn dimension, despite it being brought up numerous times in their videos. What is it there for? Do they stand by their initial theory that Starswell created it, or do they no longer believe that to be the case? More importantly, why did Cadence and Twilight manifest within it, while Cozy Glow did not? If it really was an environmental circumstance that resulted in their transformation, what is it about Cozy that was so different in this case? The next oddity comes from something Sawtooth themselves partially brought up. Why did losing all that magic remove Cozy's Alicorn form when that same thing didn't happen to Twilight? I'm admittedly a little more forgiving regarding that latter point, as I feel there are plenty of possible explanations. My favourite being that the Alicorn dimension is actually gatekeeping who gets to be a permanent Alicorn. I mean, it kind of resolves both problems at once, doesn't it? That being said, it would have been nice to hear Sawtooth try and explain their own thoughts in that video. Thirdly, the scenario regarding Celestia becoming an Alicorn from moving the Sun is not only unverifiable, it's actively contradicted. She apparently got her cutie mark from moving the Sun, but no pony has mentioned anything about wings. You'd think Twilight's play would have tried to be more accurate if that was the case, especially since she had Celestia as part of her cast. The final issue comes from that initial observation regarding Cozy Glow. Remember, Earth ponies, Pegasi, and Unicorns were not the only sources of magic back when Grogar reigned. We already know of pre-equestrian Alicorns like the one that visited Clousdale. We also know what happened when Cozy absorbed chaos magic. So absorbing pre-equestrian Alicorn magic would logically explain her transformation. Unfortunately, this gives the initial hypothesis a much greater degree of potential redundancy, since most of it can easily be explained in a much simpler way. I wouldn't say this disproves the Three Tribes hypothesis entirely, though it does mean we don't actually have a strong means of verifying it as of right now. At the very least, hopefully this puts the theory into some perspective. There's a lot about it that I would say does make sense, but it still has its issues. Maybe we'll see it updated or refined in the near future. Either way, thanks for watching, and I'm sorry for not making this video sooner.